I was to take so many risks to pass Casey. When he noticed that I came, he improved his lap time. So it was difficult to catch him, and I had to take so many risks.
Win year in year is fantastic. It's always a great pleasure, a lot of fun. Thanks to all my team, because today the bike worked very well, and proud to arrive at the first victory. I'm at the top of the championship, but I know I have difficult rivals, very strong, very hard to beat, but we are in a good shape.
Coming from all that problems we had, still it's unbelievable for me to be in the podium. I'm very, very happy and also surprised. Thanks to my team, we all are having a difficult time, but we are pushing hard.
Pedrosa's fitter and faster every race. On pole for the first time this year. But the French Grand Prix is a crapshoot. The track is wet at first and then starts to dry. Races used to be stopped and restarted when conditions changed. Under the new flag-to-flag rule, the race continues and the riders have to decide for themselves when to come into the pits and switch to their second bikes, fitted with slick tires for dry asphalt.
You have to change the bike in the right moment, no? If you change one lap later, you can lose the race.
It's a nerve-wracking decision. If the track's dry enough, slicks will be much faster. If it's still too wet, you'll feel like you're on ice. Rossi is the first to swap bikes. Too soon. Lorenzo leaves it until later. By the time he comes in, he's built a 30-second lead. When he comes back out, it's down to 7 seconds. The track's still damp. Nerves of steel required. The track's improving. Everybody's going faster. And they're getting closer. Time to push. Focus.
Thank you.
Le Mans is a great race for a different Italian, Marco Melandri. Before Pedrosa, Stoner and Lorenzo came along, Melandri looked like the next big star. In 2005, he finished second to Valentino Rossi in the World Championship. Then he joined Ducati as Casey Stoner's teammate and finished the 2008 season in 17th place. Melandri blamed the bike. Ducati blamed Melandri. Stoner's victories suggested the bike was not the problem. In fact, the Australian's results were down to his supernatural ability. His talent was masking the machine's defects. Ducati decided there was something wrong with Melandri and brought in a psychologist. Melandri left Ducati. He joined Kawasaki for 2009. That is what was left of Kawasaki's MotoGP project. A bare-bones single-rider outfit, Team Hayati Kawasaki had last year's bike and no sponsors. But at Le Mans, they had what they needed. Treacherous track conditions are an equalizer. The bike doesn't matter so much. They all have more than enough power in the wet. The race becomes a test of the rider's skill, courage, and judgment. It's Melandri's chance to show what he can do. Rossi switched to slicks on lap 6 and crashed. One lap later, Melandri makes the change. Back on the track, you're down in 11th place. Can you get to second in the next race? First thing, stay on the bike. You don't want to get hurt again. The track's drying out. Feel the grip. You can...